welcome back to the channel, everybody. I'm out here today with Sarah, and boy, we are getting down to crunch time with winter coming pretty soon, so we got a lot on our plate, and I thought I'd take this opportunity to share with you some of the ideas that we have of projects that we'd like to get done this fall. We've been talking all summer about a permanent greenhouse, and today I'm kind of going to spoil that and let you in on exactly what I think we're going to be doing, so stick around for that. But let's go start looking at some of these projects. Come on, Deuce, you might as well come with too. Well, first place we're going is up here at the medicinal herb garden, or I should say the future medicinal herb garden. Some of this will be news to Sarah, but I've been doing some thinking and kind of figuring out exactly what we're gonna do here. And I don't know if you guys can see this or not, but I kind of got a path mode out here. And I think what this is gonna be is the future, I don't know if it's gonna be decorative or not, but the walking path, it's gonna kind of snake through this whole medicinal herb garden, where we'll be able to kind of split the herbs up and have them just grow wild inside of these the quadrants. So if you look over where you can kind of see the long grass, that's where we're gonna be putting all of the herbs and different things. And then what my plan is that on each of the turns, right in the center, on each of the turns, that's where we're gonna put in an elderberry bush. We have a lot of wild elderberry bushes on the property that we found this year, and I think that we can probably move three or four of them over here and have them kind of be a focus part inside of this herb garden. So we put four of them in here and then surround everything with wild herb completely, and then do what we had kind of talked about around the perimeter of right along the perimeter here of doing
hollyhocks
way around surrounding it, and maybe do kind of like a front fenced garden gate decorative or something like that on the front of it. But yeah, I think this would be really, really cool just to have these kind of wandering walking paths through here, and who knows, maybe we can make them decorative or put down something, but I think for now it's just gonna be kind of a mowed path, and we'll get in there and get all that grass out and get our wild herbs planted in the spring.
I wish I had my sunglasses.
We can stop and get them.
Yeah.
That's what you want.
I do. The sun is blinding.
Blinding?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm really hoping to get a lot of these projects done before December 1st. That's generally when the weather starts getting a little bit nasty here. And some of them are going to need to get done a little bit quicker than that, I'm afraid, but that's kind of the goal. So
your pretzel. Say hi, pretzel.
So in the barn, Sarah covered in one of our videos not long ago that we got a bunch more chickens coming that are going to be our meat birds. And basically what we're going to do is we're going to raise a bunch of meat birds, and they're going to be the birds that help us raise more meat birds. So anyways, we're on the barn, and I got to build a new spot for them out in the barn. They got to be separate from the main egg layers, basically just so that we don't get any crossbreeding or anything like that. So they're going to kind of be like the kings and queens of the barn. They're going to get their own special spot. They're going to get their own special stuff. And so Sarah, do you want to like explain what we're kind of thinking here?
So over here, we're going to build another chicken coop with some perches across, and then we will cut a hole out so these chickens have a separate chicken run, so they'll be completely separate from our egg layers. So we'll have our egg layers over here and our meat layers over here. Meat layers, yeah, that's a thing. Mm-hmm. They lay meat. That's how easy it is to raise chicken meat. So our meat growers, so they'll be our meat birds, egg layers. But yeah, it'll be a separate coop right in here, similar to the way this is.
Similar to the back coop, very yep. Similar to the back coop, but also very similar to the layer coop. So we're gonna end up having to put in They're obviously, even though they're, hey, we got some eggs, all right. Even though we, even though their purpose is going to be for meat birds, they're obviously going to be laying eggs, so we're going to have to put in a little bit of a roosting area for them as well, over on this side. And then on the outside, here, basically, I built this little lean-to area just for wood storage. But what we're going to do is we're going to convert it into an outside coop on this side of the barn, similar to the other side. But this will be a nice little safe area for the meat birds to be able to come out and enjoy. We have, I think, a dozen coming, one rooster, so that we can, you know, fertilize the eggs and kind of create our little meat bird group for next spring. But hopefully we'll be rocking and rolling soon. So, yeah, nice little run area. Have access going back into the barn, into their special little area. And I really look forward to building this. It's going to be really neat.
So welcome to my beautiful greenhouse. Come on in. Let's try that again.
Or don't. Seems very outdoorsy.
So during one of the storms, it took out greenhouse number two, as you can see. Looks beautiful from the front, but it's not really doing its job since it took out all of our poly. So that is on our list of projects now.
Yeah, on our list of projects. And I think what we're going to end up doing is we're just going to wait until spring to pretty much deal with this.
Good thing, though, is it's still seasonably warm for mid-September, so the plants are actually still doing really great, as you can see. Frost will be coming soon. Technically, summer ends on the 22nd, but I'm hoping that we can still have a couple really good harvests, which I think is achievable considering weather for Minnesota anyways is pretty warm for September, actually, and it looks like it's going to stay mid-70s to 80s. It does get really close to frost at night, though, so we'll just kind of have to watch that and figure out some way to wrap them in the meantime.
All right, well, to look at the next thing, we're gonna head over to the planter box garden area that we built this year and check that out, and I'll kind of explain what we're gonna be doing here. So a few changes that we're gonna be making in the spring. Kind of screwed up when I put the planter boxes in here. If I'd have put them the other direction, we could have gotten twice as many. So lesson learned on that. But we're gonna end up getting those pulled up here at the end of the year and shuffled around, and that'll make for a lot more grow space and a lot more room also to walk around in here, believe it or not, even though we're going to be basically doubling the amount of planter boxes. But everything's looking good. Sarah came out here to do some trimming on tomato plants, and I kind of hijacked her and said, no, come along with me. And man, look at the bees on
they're everywhere. Beautiful.
On those chives, it's crazy.
We're single-handedly solving the honeybee problem.
Well, as you can see, I got myself quite the collection of windows and doors here. And what the plan is, I've been saving these all summer, and what the plan is those are gonna be put in our brand new greenhouse that we're gonna be building, a permanent greenhouse. So basically, the greenhouse, how it's gonna work is you're gonna go through the gate and you're gonna walk down the center aisle, and you'll go straight to the back greenhouse. These two tall pillars, if you've seen them in other videos or wondered what the heck they are, they're actually the two front supports, corner supports for the greenhouse. And basically the greenhouse is gonna sit right there on the back of the planter box garden. And the entire front is gonna be made of glass windows. The side's gonna be made of glass windows. And the entire roof is gonna be made out of corrugated plastic. And so it should be pretty well see-through, and it should be pretty awesome.
Tomatoes get out of control very fast.
Yeah, I know. I think you've cut about 3/4 of the plant off already this year.
Yep.
Just having a permanent structure that we can have for many, many years back here, I'm really looking forward to it, I know.
And it'll be nice to have it just closer to the, you know, other garden. Nice, right? To have everything nice and close for harvesting anyways. Not so much walking. Doesn't seem like a lot of walking until you do it 2 or 3 times a day,
right?
All summer long.
Yeah, and we'll be able to, you know, with the greenhouse then, we'll be able to kind of have tools close and things like that. So it'll be kind of nice to be able to come back here and have a headquarters of at least the planter box garden. Now, the other thing that I absolutely want to get done before winter is this front gate and fence. If you see down on that other end down there, I got four more sections of fence posts to put in. On this other side over here, next to the car that's for sale, if you want to buy a car, you can see I got all the posts. They're in, they're ready to rock and roll. So why are we redoing the front fence and gate? Let me tell you a little story. What happened was, last November, truck came off the road about right there, right between that mailbox and that tiny little yield sign for the snowmobilers, came down through the ditch, came through the fence here, and started knocking down all the fence all the way across, went right through here. The hay wagon wasn't sitting here at the time. It was actually sitting a little bit further over from in the yard. Went right through here, knocked out the scarecrow. We had two farm gates. They were open, so went right through the farm gates, crossed the driveway, down across the other side, and went through the fence on the other side, and then up onto the roadway and fled the scene, never to return. Thankfully, nobody was hurt as far as we know. So anyways, as you can see, I got a lot of work cut out for me. And I've spent a lot of time thinking about what we're gonna do and how we're gonna do it. So the old design had the gate basically mounted to this post here with one across the other side of the driveway that also got taken out. And then the gates closed right in the middle of the driveway there. So the design change that we're gonna do is we're gonna build a little short fence that's gonna go out here, basically right off of this corner here, and then straight across the driveway coming in 12 feet from where it originally was. Now the reason for that will be, in the future we can park the farm cart over on this side of the driveway inside the fence off area, and people will be able to pull into the driveway here, get out, get things off the farm cart, and not have to drive around in the driveway and on our property. Well, I haven't ran the tractor in a couple of weeks, so let's see if she'll start. I put a master battery disconnect on here, and instead of using a key, I installed that switch. Makes it a little bit easier for me. Don't have to worry about a key. Actually, what the deal was is the wiring setup on the key style was pretty loose and rattly. I was having some starting issues, and I thought it was a carburetor, and then I thought it maybe was fuel, and it turns out it's this stupid little key switch. So change that out to the toggle switch and problem fixed. So anyways, let's see if this thing will start. Push the clutch pedal down here. Make sure it's in neutral. That's a good thing. You don't want it in gear in case my foot happened to slip off. That'd be a bad day. You know, we get a lot of people that stop here, and we got to make it so that we have a safe area for our kids to be able to play. They like to ride their bikes out here in the driveway, and we just can't have too many people stopping in and driving around. And I think that's going to work out really nice. The new gates will go in there, come in just a little bit, and allow for not only good security here on the property, but also a really nice area for people to pull off, and if they want a tomato or a corn on the cob or whatever, they'll be able to easily get that. So any words from you?
No, I'm excited for the fence. I want my yard back.
I bet. Hey everybody, Sarah and I brought the kids out to Gooseberry Falls for today to have a little bit of fun and show you guys what it's like in Minnesota. Well, with lots of fall projects on the way, Sarah and I decided to take the kids on a mini vacation over the weekend to celebrate Sarah's 40th birthday. We started off the vacation in Gooseberry Falls, Minnesota. An absolutely breathtaking scene. The waterfalls are so pretty and majestic, so amazing. The next stop along the way was in Two Harbors, Minnesota. We walked out on the lighthouse pier, enjoyed the boats waiting out on Lake Superior. Our final destination for the weekend was Duluth, Minnesota. We spent the night down by the canal, watched a boat come in. That was pretty cool. The kids got awfully excited when that thing came rolling in. Walked out to the lighthouse and enjoyed that view. Absolutely perfect day. Couldn't have asked for better weather.
Yep.
Yeah, what did we do today? We see a big boat.
Yep. Tons.